don't like the sound of that.
Sounds like a little difference of opinion, no?
It reminds me of my old school. Bunch of barracudas there, I tell you.
I wish we could see what was happening down there.
Oh, I can oblige. I can issue a voice command to the exterior camera.
Initiate video monitoring northern quadrant.
Oh, can you hear what that little boy is saying?
I cannot hear the precise words, Miss Harriet, but the tone is most definitely disturbing.
Yeah, sounds like a bunch of name-calling.
Turn it off, Circuitous. If we can't do anything about it, I can't bear to watch it.
Monitors off.
Allow me just a moment to think. Perhaps if I ponder a bit, I can find some way to be of assistance.
Yeah, best step on it. It sounds like we could have a fight on our hands.
I'm thinking.
Hurry. This is terribly alarming.
And that's it.
What's it?
I know how to distract them and summons Mr. Henry in one swell swoop. I beg your pardon. What I meant to say was one fell swoop.
Just do what you're gonna do.
And here goes.
What's going on in here?
Detected disturbance in northern quadrant.
You mean those kids outside? Boy, they scattered in all directions when they saw me come out. Maybe it's my outfit. What do you think?
Apologies for terminating your personal cleaning process.
Well, it's called a shower, but thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, I heard those kids yelling too. It sounded like somebody was getting picked on. It's a good idea you called me. Come to think of it, it's not such a good idea. I'm standing here soaking wet. All this electricity everywhere. I could light up like a Christmas tree. I know. I'll activate my quick change booth. There! That feels better. Except I gotta adjust the fine tuner on my Vester adjuster. It keeps getting things backwards and inside out. Well, I wasn't prepared to be here just right now, so let's see. Now, what am I gonna do? I know. Perhaps the theme later has a suggestion. Aha! Aha! Oh, yeah, that got his attention. Oh, he must really be upset. He's tossed his cookies. Oh, well, no harm done. We'll fire it up, and we'll see what happens here. All right, hit me. Now, what have we here? A walking cane and a cow. I wonder if the theme later is messed up. Well, let's see. Cane. Well, what can you do for a cane? Let's see. Ladies and gentlemen, step right up and see the amazing theme later perform stupendous acts of creativity before your very eyes. Stand back, kid, you bother me. Is there... That's getting us nowhere. Well, all right, we will work on the cow. The cow. There are cows in the story of Joseph's dream. Oh, wait a minute, cows eat cows in that story. Ugh. I don't even think about that. Wait a minute. Maybe this isn't a cow. Maybe it's supposed to be a bull. See, we have Cain, and we have a bull. Cain and the bull. Cain and the bull. Cain. Cain and Abel. The very first brothers in the Bible. They fought like, like those kids out in front of my house. I feel a story coming on. It's a story about respect. Or in this case, it's about disrespect. Simulator, you've done it again. Cain didn't respect God. He wouldn't listen to what he'd been told, and he really didn't respect his kid brother, Abel. Now, God told them both to offer a sacrifice that would please him. And when you bring a sacrifice, that always means you bring your best stuff. Now, Abel was a shepherd, but Cain was a farmer.
Abel was a shepherd, and Cain was a farmer. Their sacrifices to God started this huge fight between them. Hey, Cain, what are you doing?
This is my offering, Abel. You got a problem with that?
Well, as a matter of fact, I do, Cain. They look like fruits and veggies and wheat to me.
Cain didn't seem to care that God had certain rules about sacrifices. It had to be an animal, and it had to be the best one. Now, Abel chose his best sheep for his sacrifice. Cain ignored Abel and sacrificed his moldy strawberries. So, it was no big surprise when God was happy with Abel's sacrifice and not happy with Cain's. Cain was so angry, he threw a temper tantrum.
Everyone always loves Abel best. Abel this and Abel that.
Oh, Abel, you're such a sweetie.
Abel is a scumbag. I hate him.
I should get rid of him.
That's what I should do.
Cain thought no one was listening. Have you ever thrown a fit thinking no one was around? To hear you and the bad words you were saying. Well, God is always listening, and God said, Cain, why are you so angry? If you do good, I will accept you. But if you don't do good, sin is ready to attack you. Be careful.
Sin's already attacking me. I can't do anything right. Why should I even bother trying? I'm just gonna sin. That's it. Sin! I'm just gonna sin. Sin.
Cain had a really bad attitude, didn't he? God warned him, but he just wouldn't listen. Cain was thinking,
I'm gonna do something. Wait a minute.
I know exactly what I need to do.
Whoa, I don't like the sounds of that.
Hey, Abel!
Yeah, Cain?
Hey, bro, I'm really sorry about earlier. Can we go out in the field and talk?
Well, sure, bro, anytime, yeah.
Don't do it, Abel! Don't do it! Don't go! Don't.
Oh, man, I wish you could hear me.
So, what's up, Cain?
Oh, Cain! Ow, what are you doing? Cain!
Cain killed Abel. He thought no one saw him do it. But then God said, Cain, where is your brother Abel?
Oh, how should I know? Is it my job to take care of my brother?
Man, I wouldn't talk to God that way. Then God said, Cain, what have you done?
It was about this time Cain must have realized God was no dummy. He even told him ahead of time this would happen, that sin would get him in gobs and gobs of trouble.
And it did. God knew exactly what Cain had done. And God said, your brother's blood is on the ground. Your hands killed him. Cain, from now on, you will work the ground, but it will not grow good crops for you anymore. The curse basically meant if Cain tried to grow a tomato vine, it would die before any tomatoes came out. It's too bad Cain didn't think of all this before he killed his brother. And you know what's really crazy? Cain could have solved this whole thing by just obeying God in the first place.
Well, first, Cain ignores what God told him to do, and God mad about it. And then his brother Abel tries to help him do the right thing, and what thanks does he get? Cain gets so mad he kills Abel. That's some serious disrespect. Hey, how would you rate yourself in respecting and disrespecting others. How good are you at listening to your parents? Would they say they're raising Cain or Abel? The way you treat others is pretty important stuff.
It's time to rattle your thinking cap with a round of nuts and bolts. Yeah, see if you can come up with the answer before I spell it out for you. Okay, here's a question from Genesis, the first book of the Bible. Which brother, Cain or Abel, kept flocks and looked after the animals? Do you know? Well, he is also the younger one of the two brothers. Do you know yet? It was Abel. Yeah, did I shake you up or did you nail the answer? Yeah, well, either way, thanks for playing Nuts and Bolts.
To respect or not to respect? That is the question. And it's a pretty good one, too. Every day we make tons of choices that involve respect. You decide if you're going to respect members of your family, your teachers, your neighbors, your friends, things that belong to other people. I bet if you counted up how many times you have to decide to respect or not to respect, it'd be at least 429 times a day. I got an idea. I know just the thing we need. This is my archives of unfinished projects. And Mrs. Henry calls it my junk box, but I got all kinds of great stuff in here. Oh, hey, this brings back memories. What is it? Well, I'll let you figure that out. All right. This never did work. This is just what I'm looking for. Hey, what do you think? They're beauties, aren't they? You don't know what they are. Well, these are my respectacles. The idea is, when I put them on, I see people in a whole new way. Well, I know they're not exactly stylish, but that doesn't matter. Problem is, I figured out how to make them, but I never could get the right lenses for them, so I special ordered some lenses, and that was months ago. I've been waiting for months for these lenses. I wonder who that could be. I have a good feeling about this.
Oh, hey! Just seeing if you were home.
You're just the guy I've been looking for.
Hey, if it's about that empty pizza box in your front step, I can explain
no,
that.
No. It's not about pizza. I'll bet you that I know just what you are bringing me. Because your timing is always...
Impeccable?
Eerie was more the word I had in mind.
Hey, are you having trouble with your vision?
No, I'm fine. Fine.
Are you sure? Because you just got these in the mail.
You opened my box. My box coming to me.
Well, yeah, there was bubble wrap in there. I just love popping this stuff. It really relieves stress, you know?
These are for my respectacles. If I can find them. I had them here somewhere. I can't think.
They're on your head.
Oh. Yeah. Listen, you gotta try these.
Okay.
Wow! These are amazing!
You want to try an experiment?
It doesn't involve electricity, does it?
Oh, no.
I'm still buzzing from the last time.
No. I want you to go to the door.
Okay.
And then, no. Just go to the door.
Okay.
That's my door.
Uh-huh.
Okay, you go outside. Yeah, look outside. You look around the neighborhood, you just tell me what you see.
Oh, yeah. There's that old grouch, Mr. Wilson.
Wait, this guy looks different.
How does he look different?
I don't know. This guy's kind of tough on the outside, but soft on the inside, you know? Kind of like a lollipop with one of those chewy chocolate sunnies.
Yeah, bingo! All right, how about Mrs. Deason, two doors down?
Oh, yeah, old Mrs. Deason. She's got to be 100 by now, huh? I don't see her, but there is somebody in her yard. Huh, must be your great-granddaughter. Young.
kind of pretty.
That's Mrs. Decent. You're what? Just seeing her in a new way. This is going to be a challenge. Hey, okay, look at the boy. See that kid coming up the
wall? Oh, I know this kid. Real troublemaker. Yeah. Likes to bully other kids.
You notice anything different about him?
Is he crying?
Yeah, maybe. See, I can only see him on the outside, but with spectacles, you can see him on the inside. There's always going to be another person on the inside that we can't see. Maybe that boy's mad because things are tough at home, or his big brother teases him all the time, or well, it could be a million different things.
I got to take these things off.
Well, how come?
It's too much.
Well, what do you mean?
I'm not sure I want to see the world like that all the time. It's too...
overwhelming.
Yeah.
What you got is just a little peek at how God sees us, but he isn't overwhelmed by it.
God wears respectacles?
Oh, he doesn't have to. He has perfect vision. He sees things as they truly are all the time.
Where's the polka band? Oh,
that's just my voice-activated concordance, my accordions. It's going to give us a Bible verse that has to do with what we've just been talking about.
Don't you ever invent anything normal?
No. Come on, let's go see what we got. The eyes of the Lord are everywhere, keeping watch on the wicked and the good. Proverbs 15:3.
You mean God sees everything?
Yeah, he sees everything. Every act of respect, every act of disrespect, everything that's sad and everything that's happy, every success and every failure.
That's a lot of stuff.
It sure is.
Now what?
Yeah, must be an encore. The tongue that brings healing is a tree of life, but a deceitful tongue crushes the spirit. Proverbs 15:4. Oh, yeah, that's an encore. That's the next verse. You see the connection there?
No.
Well, if you see things and see people the way God sees them, oh, it just affects everything. How you act and what you do and the things that you say, you can build people up with kind words. Or you can crush them down with mean words.
I think I've had just about enough for one day.
Trying a little experiment.
Oh, now comes the electricity, right? Oh,
no. All you gotta do, just pretend. Pretend you're wearing the respectacles and try seeing people the way God sees them for the rest of the day.
That's not how I normally operate.
Just try it. Might grow on you.
Okay.
Okay.
See you later.
See you later.
Have a good day.
Bonjour, my friends. I've got you this time. You see, I've hidden something somewhere in there. I will give you clues, and you must find the hidden item in Mr. Henry's workshop. Are you ready? Cain is known for killing his brother. But before that, he worked the land and raised fruits and vegetables. Look around the workshop and see if you can find something he may have grown way back then. Do you see it? It's a vegetable. Do you see any vegetables? And it's also green. There it is. It's broccoli. Yummy. You are a good detective, no? Yes, you are, in somewhere in there. Au revoir, my friends.
Surely there's got to be a song that would fit in here somewhere. Hey, maybe I'll play something for the respectacles in the key of C sharp. Maybe not. Well, how about that old tune that you're as pretty as a picture, but I don't want to hang you on the wall. I'll never forget old what's your name? Fine bunch, aren't they?
How do you look at other folks? Is what you're seeing really true? Well, God sees inside, and you'll be surprised when you see them as he sees you.
know, I wish I had a pair of spectacles of my own. I can barely see anything through these slits in my helmet.
My vision is not so good either, but my sense of smell is spectacular. I can smell trouble a mile off and a lovely perfume. Well, I prefer to be a bit closer to smell such a sweet fragrance.
Yeah, I gotta admit, I'm not much at this touchy-feely stuff. I mean, I got the whiz, water up my nose, my eyesight's kind of bum too.
That doesn't count you out. And remember, the best way to get respect is to show it to others. Like that little boy who was being a bully. Other kids may be afraid of him, but they don't respect him.
I have an eye chart that might be of service. I think you'll find this amusing, if not enlightening.
Whoopsie.
Uh-oh, coffee break's over. Back to bubble making.
I'm sorry that combination microwave oven and clothes dryer didn't work out the way I planned.
It's all right. I'll just keep the windows open to let the smoke out. Do you plan to be up there long?
Just a little while.
Well, can we plan to eat at 6 o'clock?
Oh, that sounds great.
You promise not to get too involved in a
project? Oh, I won't.
Thank you, Mr. Henry.
That's another good way to show respect, by keeping your word. When I say I'm going to do something, like be on time for dinner, I need to do it. Ooh, what have we here? Looks like an eye chart, like at the doctor's office. I didn't know I had one of these. Yeah, I'll try. 2B4UIC USU. R2GOD. Oh, thank God. Try the other one. Okay. 2B4UICUSUR2GOD. 2B4UICUSU. I get it. 2B4UICUSUR2GOD. This must be some kind of spiritual eye chart. For me to really be for you, I need to see you the way that God does. To be for you, I see you as you are to God. I like it.
Professor Henry calling. Mr. Henry.
Oh, I'm here, brother. I'm here.
I've been aware of the goings-on at your shop today, and it sent me thinking back to our childhood. Do you remember our treehouse?
Oh, boy, do I.
Hey, you invented gadgets while I surveyed the neighborhood for any topographic abnormalities that might hint to ancient civilizations buried beneath our subdivision.
I'll never forget the time you fell through that trap door I added.
And neither will I.
Oh, but you've forgiven me for that.
Most assuredly.
Oh, okay.
But I'll never touch another string attached to a note that says, pull here for a big surprise.
I was young and foolish.
And I was young and on my way to breaking my arm, but that's not why I popped in.
Well, what brings you by this time?
Some more trees.
Oh, I think our tree house was an old oak tree.
I'm thinking about a wee little man.
Oh, you mean Zacchaeus?
Precisely. He was a man who received little respect.
Oh, yeah. He was a tax collector. In those days, they often charged a lot more than they had to. They got into a lot of trouble then.
Yeah. And there was nothing anyone could do to stop them.
He was like that neighborhood bully who used to take our milk money. Remember him?
Oh, don't remind me. So, I thought it might be advantageous to consider the horticulture of the period to better understand sycamore trees. I have a fascinating collection of petrified wood from Jericho.
And I could just... What if we just stick with the story without the gardening lesson?
Well, if we want to pare it down to basics...
Yeah, we do. We want to...
Very well, then. If I recall correctly, and I'm sure that I do, our story takes place in the town of Jericho. We will focus on Zacchaeus, who was considerably shorter than his contemporaries. We'll also need Jesus and his disciples. And a large crowd of people who keep Zacchaeus from being able to see anything. Now, observe what happens.
Well, this is just great. I don't suppose anybody let me step up front.
Hey,
Aren't you Zacchaeus? A tax collector?
You're always getting rich at our expense. You always force us to pay back more than we should.
Yeah, and I don't think you deserve to see Jesus. I don't think he'd want to see you anyway.
So I guess that means you won't let me climb on your shoulders and look around?
Oh, I think I see Jesus coming.
This is just great. Think, Zacchaeus, think. Man, why do I have to be so short? Why couldn't I be as tall as a
tree?
It's climb time.
Okay, I'm going out on a limb here. Balance. It's all about balance.
Hey, you.
Hey, who?
You who?
Me who?
Yes, you. You in the tree. Zacchaeus. Hurry up and come down from there. I'm going to your house.
What? His house?
His house?
Yes.
Right out of the way. Out of the way. Special friend of Jesus coming through. Sorry I can't stay.
And that's just what happened. Jesus went to the home of the tax collector, Zacchaeus.
Hey, it's nice to be here with you, Jesus. But,
But what?
Why'd you choose to hang out in the home of a cheating weasel?
Ouch.
Because I came to turn the world upside down. To change the lives of tax collectors and little kids and even you, nameless member of the crowd.
Nobody ever treated me like a real person before.
It's tough for you. You see Zacchaeus as who he's always been. But I can also see him as who he's becoming.
Him? Well, why not me? I mean, is it impossible to think that I could change? I'm done. I'm done with my cheating and my stealing and my ripping people off. I'm turning over a whole new leaf. Is there anybody here that I've ever stolen from? Tell you what I'm going to do, Jesus, just to show you that I've changed. If there's anybody here that I've stolen from, I'll give them back four times what I owe.
But the law says you don't have to pay back that much.
We're not talking about pocket change here. We're talking about a change of heart. And what you're seeing here is a change of heart.
I like your thinking.
What do you think I learned?
So, we see that Zacchaeus came to respect people in a whole new way. He formerly used his power to push people around, but not anymore.
I love that story.
It's a fine example. Perhaps we should all occasionally climb a tree to gain a different perspective.
Or maybe just have a change of heart.
Well, I talk now about sycamore trees, their origin and environmental factors contributing to their growth.
Listen, you've done such a great job with the story. I don't think you can top yourself.
How kind.
I respect you as an archaeologist, brother, but I'm sure you've got lots more to say. I love you like a brother, but frankly, you'd better quit while you're on top.
Very well. I've got rolls of scrolls to decipher.
You have fun.
Now, where did I put... Oh, yes, yes. Okay, on to new adventures.
What a guy.
Now it's time to test your wits, because you're on the hot seat. Kane's first mistake was A, growing vegetables, B, being the older brother, or C, not doing as God told him. The correct answer is C. If Cain had respected God by obeying him, he would have saved himself a ton of trouble. Fill in the blank of Proverbs 15:4. Healing words give us A, life, B, trouble, or C, prizes. The right answer is A. Proverbs 15:4 says that healing words give us life. One way to get better at respecting others is to A, consider how much money they make, B, consider how God sees them, or C, consider yourself a nice person. I think the right answer is B, don't you? That's right! One way to get better at respecting others is to consider how God sees them. All right, keep you cool to your next shot at the hot seat!
All right, I got some good news. You know those kids that were having a big old fight this morning? They struck up a friendship.
The one who was acting so tough, well, he realized that, well, he was mad about other things. He wasn't mad at the kid he was about to hit. And that kid, well, he got courageous and told the bully that he didn't want to fight. In fact, he wanted them to be friends. And he's got a new soccer ball, so now the two of them are going down to the park to kick that around instead of each other. Wouldn't it be great if we could see others through God's eyes? And if others could do the same? Instead of being like Cain, who had some serious attitude problems, we'd be more like Zacchaeus, who was willing to see his mistakes and change. People are gonna get all inside out and backwards, just like my vest did, but when you really respect people, you can work things out.
Mr. Henry, dinner time.
I hear lots of music.
I'll be right there, dear. And I will be, because you know, keeping your word, that's a big part of showing respect for others. Think about that. See you later.